Now, those of you new to the show or reef keeping will say, what do you mean live rock and dead rock? Live sand and dead sand. Live sand just means there's beneficial bacteria in the sand. The sand isn't actually alive. When I first went to my first reef store, the guy's throwing all the stuff at me when I thought, let me just check this out. Let me see if it's something that I actually want to get into. And he's saying, you need this and that and blah, 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 and a skimmer and that. You're going to need live sand, live rock. I'm like, what the hell? Live rock has the beneficial bacteria. Now, those of you starting out in the hobby, I always recommend never, ever, ever buy live anything. If you go to the store and you buy a live rock out of an aquarium, that's a good thing, right? Because it already has bacteria on it. And that bacteria is going to be put in your tank from that rock, and it's going to grow and fester and spread. That's what we call cycling your tank. You want to get a lot of that beneficial bacteria in your tank. What if that tank come, that bacteria-ridden rock, live rock, comes with parasites? It's happened. Happened to me. So I would just buy dead rock, rock that's not wet, rock that's just sitting on the shelf, bring it home, just rinse it off under the faucet, put it in your tank. The bacteria will colonize on it and it will grow. Now, what if you have a brand new tank with no bacteria? What do you do? Well, some people buy some hardy fish that are cheap, so when they die, and they more than likely will die because the tank hasn't been cycled, there's not enough bacteria in it, and all the ammonia from the fish waste and uneaten food is gonna skyrocket and it's going to kill them because it's toxic. Your brand new tank will skyrocket to 100% ammonia, let's just say, right? And then it'll suddenly drop and level off. When it spikes, most fish, if not all, will die. That's really mean to put your fish through that. You know what I do? All I did was I fed the tank with no fish in it. It was just clean salt water, no bacteria. I took some fish food, frozen shrimp. I put a cube of frozen shrimp in the tank, and I used pellet food. I would sprinkle pellet food in there, you know, once a day, just a little pinch, and then every few days, just a little pinch. And it would break down, and then it would go. And then I would buy an ammonia test kit, and I would see what's going on, okay? Now, if you really have patience, and you should in this hobby, you should let that tank cycle, and I know I couldn't do it either, for like 6 weeks. You could buy a live rock, or two, or three, or five, or 20 pounds of it, whatever. Put it all in there. Let it cycle through. Don't put any fish in there, because with that live rock could come parasites, all right? Those parasites will die within 6 weeks. I've got videos on the ick parasite and the marine velvet parasite and how their life cycle is, so I'm not going to get into it now, but 6 weeks minimum is what you need to do. Keep your main aquarium empty with no fish for 6 weeks, and the parasites will die without adding any chemicals or anything, okay? Saltwater tank 101 when you're starting a new tank. Also, avoid the temptation of getting a new fish once a week or once every few days. I did that in the beginning. I didn't listen to people. I said, oh, it'll be fine. It wasn't fine, because what happens is the tank isn't used to all that bio load, all that extra urine and all that extra fish crap, and you're gonna wanna feed them more because we all love seeing our fish eat, right? All that extra food that doesn't get eaten is gonna break down and rot, and all the urine, ammonia, fish waste, and food that breaks down, it's gonna turn into toxic, and it's gonna go through the cycle, and it's gonna turn into nitrates, which are bad. It's gonna pollute your water with toxins, and fish will die. So what you wanna do is you wanna have your bacteria build up slowly over time. Let it handle the amount of bio load that you have. Once it's there, and how do you know? It's safe to put a new fish in once a month. That's the rule of thumb. Just have patience and go slow. Your fish will thrive, they'll be healthy, and everything will be awesome. So thank you for watching again. Take care, you guys. Subscribe and share it out.